So I've changed the top side of the thread because the underside is going to be white. So I'm going to leave the white thread underneath, but change the top side. You can actually change the foot at this point as well and use an ordinary foot, even though you can actually use the same foot. And but you know what makes it easier, so you might as well just change the foot as well. Now you can get even wider foots, and if you have problems using markings, having problems with going on a straight line, then you can get a wider foot as well that you can use as a guide. Now to start this off, this is the bottom end of the gumis. You turn that in and then fold it over so that the raw unselvaged edge, the start of this, is actually taken in. Now the other thing you can do is, if you think that you know, when you turn it over your fabric is going to stick out, you can fold it into a triangle and then fold it in, whereby you are guaranteed to have that protruding corner going inwards. And that is actually a better way of doing it, because it will hide away any ugliness or any unevenness towards the inside. So I've triangled that, folded it like this and taken it towards the inside, and then I'm going to just top stitch this from the right side of the gumis, going about half an inch of a margin towards the inside, because the dori itself is quite wide and I want to stitch fairly close to the edge of the dori. Even your fabric, just sort of sweep it, lift your foot and slightly grab the fabric from the back, just tug on it so that it feeds evenly. Again, sweep it back, lift the foot to get any unevenness out, and guide yourself along, and do this repeatedly, because it will stop any puckering or any unevenness as you guide yourself upwards. Go about half an inch or a centimeter past the jah opening, leave your needle down and pivot the fabric around, even out the opening so that there's no unevenness. Again, leave your needle down, pivot the fabric around, sweep the fabric backwards and slightly tug on the fabric so that your fabric is guided. Now on gumiza which are tight or the daman is very small, you can actually unpick the daman and widen it quite a bit by using this technique, this method. Sufficiently enough to overcome, you know, the problems of a gumiz being tight on the hips. So all we're doing here is stretching that out so that the white dori is slightly predominant, and stitching down. So every now and then we're sweeping the fabric and just evening it out. Again at the corner here, triangle this out, fold it over and slip over. finished result of this kameez. Now, actually, the proof of the pudding is in the eating. What we're going to have to do is hopefully finish this and have a look and see if we've managed to overcome the problem of what we started with, and that was that the kameez was coming out tight on the hips. Have we managed to open it up sufficiently in order to overcome that problem? I think by the opening on this now is a lot wider, and I would reckon that this would have opened it up quite sufficiently to overcome that problem. So each time you go through that sweeping motion, make sure you lift the foot up and even the fabric out. That just balances it and will give you a far neater and better result. Twist. And it's a quite an easy process to actually carry out.